Now you are well aware of how you can communicate with your students through Google Classroom. But how can you share or create materials for them? Let's explore. Study materials could be information or assignments or videos, or even your pre-existing teaching aids you may have created earlier. For that, we can access the classwork tab you see here. You could first create a topic that you want your students to understand and add different kinds of materials to it. You can click here and give a name to the topic. With that, you will see the name of your topic listed on the left here. Now let's add some material to this topic. It's crucial to give your material some appropriate title and description. Once you do that, you have an option to add some material that you've already prepared or the option to create one. Let's try creating or importing a Google Doc in this video, and in the upcoming videos, we can look at other options. We can click on Create and select Docs, and that will open a new document. We can give it a name by editing this part here. Now, most people assume that Google Docs is just about letters and words, but trust me, there's lots more to it. Let me give you a few examples. You could click on Tools, select Voice Typing, select your language, and see magic. We begin the recording now. An equation says that two things are equal. Full stop. And now we stop the recording. Interesting, isn't it? You can also insert an image from your computer. Or you could also search for an image on the web, select it, and add it to the document. You can also include equations and special characters. You could also redirect your students to an external website by inserting a link in the doc, like this. But make sure you have vetted the website prior to sharing it. And guess what? You don't need to keep saving it. It keeps getting auto-saved every time you add information. There are many more features, but we'll keep that for later. We can now close the doc by closing the tab. You will see your Google Doc here now. If you don't see it updated, just refresh the page. You can then assign it to your topic by clicking here and selecting the topic. And you can choose if you want to share it with all your students or just a select few. After you've added enough information, you can either post it immediately or schedule it for a later date, or simply just save your information. Let's post it for now. You can now see that the material will appear in your stream section, and your students as well will be able to see it in the stream section. The good thing is that unless you allow them, the students will not be able to edit your docs. They can just view them. That's how easy it is to share a Google Doc file with your students. You can use Google Docs on any smartphone, laptop, or tablet. You can even edit it while you're offline, and it'll sync changes once you go online. So Google Docs is one way in which you can share material with your students. Watch the next video to know how you could share beautiful presentations with your students. See you there.